Hey guys, today I'm going to be reviewing the book The Lady Elizabeth by Alison Weir. This is a novel based around the early life of Queen Elizabeth I, who was the daughter of King Henry VIII. And Alison Weir doesn't disappoint again. She did a really good job. There were some things that I had issues with, but overall, this is a really good portrayal of the early life of Elizabeth I before she becomes Queen of England. So the book begins when Elizabeth is about 3 years old. It begins after the death of her mother, Anne Boleyn, and it ends when she is, I believe, 25, when she becomes queen. That's when it ends. And I really enjoyed this book. It was, it explains the whole early life of Elizabeth and kind of what made her be the queen that she was. She talks about not wanting to marry, and Alison Weir goes into why that was, some of the reasons that could be. For example, she saw, she probably knew of her own mother's beheading, and she also saw Catherine Howard. She didn't actually see it, but she knew of Catherine Howard's beheading, and just saw the way, you know, women were treated during the Middle Ages, during this time. And she also probably saw and heard about the Queen Catherine's childbirth and how she just ended up dying from it. So she decided not to marry. Now, the only problem I had with the book was the relation, quote unquote, with the kind of lascivious relationship between Elizabeth and Tom Seymour, who became her stepfather. It has been historically proven that Tom Seymour did come and was really, we don't know if he truly molested her, but kind of sexual harassment in a way. I guess that's what it'd be considered. He would come in when she was in various states of undress. He would smack her on, you know, and things of that nature, more sexual harassment, but we don't know if he actually, like, raped her, and that probably also had an effect. But Alison Weir kind of says that, in a way, partially, that Elizabeth was to blame for that. But Elizabeth was 14 years old, and she kind of made allusions in the book that Elizabeth was to blame, but Elizabeth was a child, and that she kind of let him on, but I don't know how true that was. But overall, I loved seeing the different relationships between Elizabeth and the various people, such as Mary, her sister, Mary Tudor, and her brother, and people that, you know, she knew from childhood came back into her life, and when she becomes queen, or they believe she is ready to become queen, they kind of come back in her life. And I really liked that kind of dynamic, and I really like Elizabeth's character, the way she was portrayed for the most part. She was really good at playing people, and she's known for doing this in her reign, especially when it came to marriage. I don't feel like I'm giving anything away because this really isn't in the book. When she becomes queen, she pretty much would use, "Oh yeah, I'm gonna marry you, so and so, great king, prince, whatever, to try and get their alliance, and then would like, oh, I decided not to. She was really good at knowing, because she was probably really sought after, so she knew to, she kind of knew how to play the game in a way. She knew how to play the game of life and kind of play people. So I liked the way she was portrayed. She was really intelligent, and she was one of the greatest monarchs. You know, that she's known for a lot of different, like, her time period was known, you know, the Elizabethan era was known for a lot of wonderful discoveries and a lot of wonderful creations. So this novel is a really good read for anyone that is into historical fiction. Alison Weir does it again. I don't think I've read any really horrendous books by Alison Weir at all. I think a lot of them are really well done. You can tell that she does her research and things of that nature, so I really enjoy that. So that's all for this book review, and now I want to say that I do have everything set up for my Patreon, but I don't have any videos up there yet because I'm deciding what to put on there. I'm reading a book right now that a book review that I'm going to do kind of talk about on the Patreon channel. I want to get the Patreon channel mostly talking about religion and my views on certain aspects of religion. So that's all set up, and I will see you guys in the next video. Bye, guys.